So you're telling me the new champion was created by Hecarim and Nico, topped off with some Zoe dust. Thinking emoji. What is going on, Team Pro Guides? My name is Zyrene, and today we present to you the only Lillia guide you will ever need. We broke down the champion to its basics and even pranced through all the advanced strategies that she can execute. Lillia is a unique champion with high carry potential, so make sure you watch until the end so you can stomp the noobs with her. For our question of the day, which two champions would you like to see combined to create a new character? If I were to create a new one, I would probably go with Cassiopeia and Gnar. Just imagine a little snake Yordle slithering around, transforming into a bigger snake to snare opponents. Leave your answers in the comment section below and join our Discord to discuss with the community what you think. I look forward to reading your answers to see what you come up with. And lastly, before we get started, make sure to check out ProGuides.com. There we have courses from your favorite pro players like Doublelift and many challenger level coaches who can take your gameplay to the next level. We also have daily live classes from top tier instructors like Zyrene and Mike Young. Don't miss out on these great opportunities to improve and join the community. With that being said, let's jump straight into the video. Lillia is wild. She has insane damage output with crazy mobility that anyone can pilot to win games. She is a character that will be played as a magic damage bruiser, similar to Irelia, Darius, and Hecarim, but the AP version, which kind of makes me think it's a little bit more like a Sylas. This means that she will be a pseudo frontliner that will usually enter fights after the initial engagement has happened. The great thing about her is that she makes it painfully obvious to teammates that they need to go in if she lands her crowd controlling abilities, allowing her to follow in. She has a lot of flexibility, and we will likely see different styles of gameplay varying from full damage, glacial GLP, and even straight up full tank to abuse her passive. We've already covered the basics of Lillia's abilities in our champion spotlight video on her, but we will speed run her abilities here for you if you haven't watched it yet. Starting with Lillia's passive, Dream Laden Bow. Her abilities apply Dream Dust to enemies, dealing 5% of the target's maximum health over 3 seconds. The Q, also known as Blooming Blows, lets her swing her sensor around her, dealing extra damage on the outer ring. Diving into her passive, this gives her prance stacks that lets Lillia move faster when she lands her abilities. Lillia's W, watch out! Eep! Creates a target circle 150 units away from her that deals magic damage and does more damage in the middle. Her E, Swirl Seed, allows her to lob a ball that will continue rolling until it hits something, which it will then deal magic damage in a cone and slow them. Lastly, Lillia's ultimate casts a lullaby over all targetable enemy champions affected by Dream Dust, rendering them drowsy for 1.5 seconds, which they will then fall asleep for a few seconds. Now that we've broken down the basics of her abilities, let's talk about the advanced tactics. Starting off with my favorite, the bowling ball. A very common play you will see when Lillia is leaving Fountain is shooting her Swirl Seed down one of the lanes with a potential strike to set up one of her teammates. Let's break it down for you to understand. It'll be mostly common down the mid lane, but can be done to top and bot if enemies are hitting your turrets. You stand in select locations and cast your E in a specific spot, which will allow your ball to travel until it collides with something. More often than not, you'll probably just hit a minion, but for the few times it connects with a champion, you've just acquired yourself a YouTube clip, my friend. From there, if it hits an enemy champion, you can activate your ultimate, which will put the enemy to sleep, allowing your respective laner to all in them. As people play the game more, more variations of this play will become popular, like sending a ball from Dragon to Baron to check for vision, so be ready for those highlight plays. Now for the actual bread and butter combo on the champion, and what you can do to make plays on the map. When you're going in for ganks, try to get in range to land your Q so you get bonus movement speed, then reposition to land your Swirl Seed on the enemy. Once you land your E, the enemy will be slowed, which will give you an opportunity to activate W and try to hit it in that sweet spot to deal increased damage. And trust me, not only do you deal more damage, that deep satisfying sound is lovely to hear when you smack an enemy champion straight in the middle. From there, you can run down your opponents or disengage with your extra movement speed. But let's say you have your ultimate available. In that case, enter the lane to gank and apply your Q onto the enemy champion to place a Dream Dust on them and use your ultimate. While they are drowsy, they will be slowed, so land your Swirl Seed here before they sleep. While they're sleeping, you can guarantee that your W sweet spot will land and then chase them down from there. Is it just me or am I getting Zoe vibes from reading out how she wants to approach ganks? Going into her runes and different builds we're likely to see, let's start off with a couple of different setups that you can run in both jungle and top lane. Since Lillia doesn't have any built-in healing, more often than not, you're likely to see the Ravenous Hunter rune somewhere in the build in order to give her a form of sustain. Starting off with the first page, it's a more burst-oriented page. Electrocute, Sudden Impact, Eyeball Collection, Ravenous Hunter, followed with Nimbus Cloak and Celerity. This page gives Lillia the ability to enter a lane and burst opponents as fast as possible before running off to continue farming. We recommend running this page into squishy team compositions to take out targets even faster. Our second page will consist of sustained damage with Conqueror, Presence of Mind, Tenacity, Last Stand, with Sudden Impact, and Ravenous Hunter. This page should be run into multiple tanks because fights will last long enough for Lillia to charge up Conqueror with all her abilities and auto attacks. Since she spams her Q so often, she'll get a lot of sustain and crazy damage output with her tank shredding passive. Our third page in the jungle will consist of Phase Rush, Nimbus Cloak, Celerity, Water Walking, with Sudden Impact, and Ravenous Hunter. You want to run this page when the first two options don't match the game that you're playing, as this page will give you crazy amounts of movement to disengage, to run around extremely quickly, and to dominate teamfights. Lastly, we want to include one spicy rune page top lane players may eventually pick up. Starting out, we have Glacial Augment, Magical Footwear, Biscuit Delivery, Approach Velocity, with Sudden Impact, and Ravenous Hunter. This page can be paired up with GLP or Twin Shadow purchases to chase opponents and have crazy team fights set up for your teammates. Run this page if you're against a squishy top laner that has mobility issues. Otherwise, you should probably just stick to the previous rune pages that we discussed in the top lane. Now that we understand a couple of different rune pages that can be run on Lillia, let's cover all the potential builds she can go into. The core build will always consist of the AP jungle item, followed by boots of your choice, followed by either Liandry's or Rylai's first. Regardless of which one you build first, you'll always want to build the other one after because they synergize really well together. Let's break it down with the effects. Rylai's Crystal Scepter slows enemies with damaging abilities, so this means that all of Lillia's abilities will slow enemies, but the kicker is in Lillia's passive, which is Dream Dust, which deals damage over 3 seconds, so if the enemy gets out of range, you'll continue slowing enemies with your damage over time. Now pair all this up with Liandry's Torment, which deals damage over 3 seconds, but it ticks every 0.5 seconds. As you can see, the rest of this will become history as nobody's getting away from Lillia anytime soon. If all of that wasn't enough to get your attention, Liandry's damage is amplified up to 7.5% of a target's maximum health if they're slowed, so shredding tanks and chasing squishies will be no problem for Lillia. We're not going to go too in-depth with the remainder of Lillia's build, as you can adapt accordingly to each situation, but we suggest giving Spirit Visage a try when you're against heavy magic damage compositions because you'll never die with all your sustain. Now that we know her basic ganking combo and build, let's pull everything we know about the champion and break it down to the nitty-gritty with the tips and tricks. Number 1. Whenever you gain a Prance stack, the stack you just gained actually stays for a while compared to when they start diminishing. Only until you actually lose a stack do the numbers start depleting really quickly, so pay really close attention to her Q passive and learn to abuse it for movement speed. 2. Her activated Q swing does extra true damage on the outer ring, so put heavy emphasis on landing this ability there. If you land your Q in the inner part, you're essentially losing half your damage output, so avoid that if possible. 3. Similarly to Aurelion's Soul E, there is a visible indicator determining the maximum range that your ability can travel. In Lillia's case, her Swirl Seed will be marked on terrain, or it will crash into a champion or minion along the way. This tool can be used to ping where the ball may go, so your teammates are on the same page as you in an intense situation. 4. On the topic of her E, make sure you do not fire this ability over someone, otherwise you will miss. Make sure to aim short and let the rolling do all the work for you. A quick mechanic that we haven't discussed yet is upon impact, her E will spread into a small cone, hitting enemies. Use this while you're ganking if an enemy champion is hiding behind minions, because you are more likely to land it rather than going for a direct hit. 5. Surprisingly, Lillia is actually not the strongest champion early on. Against champions with heavy invading tools like Lee Sin, Elise, and Nidalee, purchase pink wards and place them in entrances so you can create a game plan around them to stay ahead of the curve. 6. Here are a couple of pointers to make your jungle clear a bit smoother in the early game. Abuse your 300 auto attack range. Yeah, Lillia's auto attack is actually considered ranged. We see you guys going into customs and trying to buy Titanic Hydra. You can hypothetically do blue buff without the camp hitting you once if you kite and weave around it perfectly. Make sure to pull your camps to wherever you plan on going to, so you'll speed up the time you are moving between camps. 7. Now here are a couple of tips to make jungle clear a lot faster once you have Runic Echoes. While you're pulling blue buff, throw your E at Gromp and do both camps at the same time. Heavily use your passive and keep it running between each camp to prance around quicker. Use your E on the next camp that you plan on going to, so you can proc them faster and keep your movement speed buff going. That concludes our latest video on Lillia. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to join our Discord below, where we do tons of coaching giveaways and community events. Lastly, don't forget to visit our website at ProGuides.com, where you can receive coaching from pro players, watch live classes, and improve with courses from those pro players. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe for more content. Thank you very much for watching, and good luck on the Rift.